to you how many neurological complications did you have?
I can answer you absolutely precisely. My neurologist in the report recently had 270 operations and 17
severe
neurological complications, 0.05%. This is a question to a certain degree about the cause of scoliosis, the fact that the spinal cord growth doesn't correlate with the growth of the spine. You have to be, this is very difficult to connect them, but I'm trying to connect them. How then? Professor Dudin may answer this question. Why? Do we have, when we have such a correlation between the growth of the spine and the spinal cord, why do we have the complication in the form of scoliosis, and why when we treat the scoliosis, when you increase the growth of the spine and at the same time, this leads to huge incorrelation between spinal cord and spine? Why then you have so few neurological complications? Since God, that there are so few, but how do you explain this? Your comment is very justified, but I think the answer would be as follows. If we do not register these complications, it doesn't mean that they do not exist. This is the first part of the answer, now the second part of the answer. The complications may be not only neurological, they may be concealed complications concealed beneath the rigid metallic fixation of the spine. If you remove these structures, you will see all the complications. Third part of the answer is that you are absolutely right that we artificially elongate the spine, and the fact is that at the third stage of pathogenesis, the factor of non-conjugation between the bone, spine and doesn't play any role. The conjugation plays a role as a triggering mechanism for scoliosis, and then we have the compensatory reactions of third grade that are connected with your cubicular lobe. When the wedge for the intervertebra increases, but the non-conjugation doesn't play its primary role. And fourth part of the answer will be when the mathematical solution, and I thank our young prodigies in mathematics, we've managed for the first time to describe the mathematical model that is really working. These are young students, fourth year students from the Institute of Precise Mechanics and Optics, who managed to show with this model that the state of conjugation is 1 to 2% of the length of the spine. Or actually the physiological length of the chest
bone.
The compensation of this issue is already initiated. And may I answer first to this answer, to this question? Yes, please. You say that we are speaking about idiopathic scoliosis. We have here Dr. Ishak, who researches for many years the position of the spine in the spinal channel in different deformities. From my point of view,
these
correlations of the length of the spine and the spinal cord do not play a role in the formation of the complications. In our clinic, we have a certain order. When we have the deformity of the spine higher than 90 degrees, if I'm not mistaken, the patient undergoes a tractional sampling.
Then
we make an X-ray at this point, and the neurologist examines the patient. In some very few cases, well, actually, this data we receive out of this sample impact our tactics. In some very few cases, we have symptoms of pyramidal
явность сосудистого генеза. То есть, с моей точки зрения, это не результат вот этого несоответствия одного другому, а результат очень сложный и усложняющийся взаимоотношений в канале между дуральным лицом и
космическим
кругом. Умеренных градусов до 70-80 вообще не должно быть неврологических
отклонений. Это скорее всего результат
и у нас такие
результаты были, когда мы работали с хирургом. И у нас также были такие ошибки у хирурга. Так что это мой точка зрения. Спасибо.
Можно у меня вопрос?